have great taste, especially with your radio choice. Thank you for spending a little time with Gary and Bristol on Kiss Country 93.7.
Kenny Chesney, get along. Kiss Country 93.7. Happy Friday. It's Gary and Bristol. Don't forget, about an hour from now, we're going to load you up with some more Kane Brown tickets. His concert next Saturday is going to be in Arlington there at the Globe Life Field. That's the old Texas Rangers Stadium. And yesterday, we got to hang out with an amazing lady, this week's recipient of the Kiss Country Caught in the Act Award. If you didn't hear when Bristol and I called Wendy Harville, just listen in.
Hello.
Wendy Harville.
Yes.
You are in so much trouble.
Okay.
Good morning. It's Gary and Bristol from Kiss Country 93.7.
All right.
Your hubby Jack has told on you. Oh, my goodness.
And I clearly need to come and sit at your knee and learn the lessons, because you have got this man thinking you have hung the moon, woman.
Uh-oh.
And I just want to know how he didn't put a ring on it any faster.
Oh, my goodness.
Can we read this to you?
Yes, please do.
He says, I want to tell you just a little bit about Wendy Harville, my wife. I've known this magnificent lady going on 35 years, and I've been fortunate enough to call her my wife for almost 28 years. Wendy is the most loving, kindest, most forgiving, giving, and godly woman I have ever known. Her life revolves around doing for others. Together, we've raised three wonderful boys and are currently raising four of our nine grandkids. After our boys were grown, she took on the responsibility of raising our first two granddaughters. They were 2 years and 1 year old at the time and are currently 13 and 12 now. She has taken on the responsibility of raising two of our grandsons, ages 11 months and 5 years old. Wendy does everything for her family, and there's a reason why that's in all caps, right? Her children, her grandchildren, and anyone she knows. She keeps a magnificent and orderly house. She pays all the bills and still makes time to work as a full-time real estate appraiser. This woman absolutely amazing. She supports our first responders, her church, and many other organizations on a monetary basis annually. She asks for nothing, yet gives everything that she has. Wendy knows many, many people in the area, and they all know how she is and what she puts up with and everything she does. I kind of feel like he's glossing over something there, don't you?
That is so sweet of him.
What she puts up with, Wendy never seeks praise of any kind, although there are many. I myself truly believe there is nobody more deserving to be acknowledged than my wife, Wendy. This woman is an angel sent directly from God, and I am blessed that he sent her to me.
Oh, that is so sweet.
Wow. Wow. Has he ever written something like that for you on a Valentine's card?
No, never.
Golly.
So this is a little out of character.
Wow. I cannot believe that.
Is he in trouble for something?
No, he's not in trouble for anything.
I mean, because this is like flowers to the 10th degree.
Oh, my goodness. Yes.
I'm telling you.
Well, Wendy, you are this week's recipient of the Kiss Country Caught in the Act Award, and that means you get goodies. You get a $50 gift certificate to Magnolia Pit Barbecue.
Oh, wow.
And I guess you could take Jack with you if you wanted. Yeah.
Yeah, I guess I can do that. Oh, I cannot believe he did that.
Wow.
So loving of him.
Okay, so tell me, what's the toughest part of raising the grandkids?
Well, some of it's just patience and at our age.
Yeah. I understand.
Gary ran out of patience a long time ago. That well has run dry.
But sometimes you just got to do what you got to do, yeah. You know.
Well, I am so thankful that there's people like you that live amongst us that give the rest of us somebody to look up to.
Oh, well, thank you. I really do appreciate everything.
Kiss Country 93.7 knows that you can go anywhere to hear about the bad news. That's why we celebrate those who are doing good. Coaches, teachers, and normal, everyday people who have made it their priority to serve others. Those are the people we brag about. And every Thursday, we announce the latest recipient of the Kiss Country Caught in the Act Award. Know someone who's worthy of our praise? Be sure to nominate them, and they could get a big old dose of Kiss Country love and a $50 gift certificate from Magnolia Pit Barbecue. Get that nomination started now in your Kiss Country app.
Happy Friday. We finally made it. Kiss Country 93.7. It's Gary and Bristol. Thank you for waking up with us. Justin Moore there. This is My Dirt. And some weird news yesterday about Justin Moore. He was supposed to be in Irving, Texas on October the 6th. And we just got notice yesterday that they're going to be canceling that show. I don't know exactly why or what's going on there, but if you bought tickets for that particular concert, just know it won't be long. They'll be telling you exactly what to do to get your refunds on that. Oh, a little heads up as far as traffic goes. Tomorrow, if you're going to be driving around in West Shreveport, starting at 6 o'clock tomorrow morning, the Burt Coons overpass over I-20 in West Shreveport going to be closed pretty much all day long. They're having to work on that bridge there. It's about 2 miles west of the Pines Road interchange with I-20. They say just one day, but it is going to be closed. So start thinking about that. If you normally use that area on a Saturday, you're going to need to find another way.
They're like a Band-Aid for all of life's bobos. It's Gary and Bristol only on Kiss Country 93.7.
911, what's your emergency?
It's Gary and Bristol. If you're not having fun yet, you might need someone to call 911 for you. Kiss Country 93.7.
Kiss Country 93.7. Luke Combs, ain't no love in Oklahoma. You think there ain't no love there now? Just wait. November 30th, when they show up in Death Valley.
Oh, hello.
Yeah, buddy. Welcome to the SEC.
I love you got your LSU on.
Yes, ma'am.
I'm going out to watch the game tomorrow night, so I'm wearing my LSU tomorrow.
I don't know why I'm wearing it. I won't be able to watch the game.
Oh, that's right. I forgot.
Yeah, shut up, Bristol.
Kick the dish.
I have a choice, right?
Oh, it is ticket trivia time. On the flip side, we can send you to go see some live entertainment,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
We
got a couple of tickets for the big show next Saturday night, Kane Brown in Arlington there at the old Texas Ranger Stadium, Globe Life Field. And today's question, of course, yesterday we played Don't Say Today. Just over a third of all people say they would choose this as their last meal.
Ain't no way.
What is it?
No, this can't be right.
That's what they say. Just over a third of all people say they would choose this as their last meal. What would that last meal be? The main course, if you will. 725-5477, 725-KISS, Country 93.7. Happy Friday. It's Gary and Bristol. I told you we were in party mode. We don't care if Mother Nature didn't get the memo.
Right? I'm partying that it's at least a little bit cooler, right?
Yeah, no doubt.
I mean,
it's like 70 for a low in the morning.
And I had to tell you, when I was coming in this morning, it's staying darker later.
Yeah. Okay, we mentioned a second ago it is Consolation Friday. Yes, the ticket trivia question, we got the winner and everything. They got the Kane Brown tickets, but just discovered this morning we got another 4-pack of tickets for the Ray Forcier Memorial Rodeo that's tonight and tomorrow in Benton.
Hey.
4 tickets. You and the whole fam can go.
Tight-fitting jeans. Oh, I'm sorry, what?
She's sitting on top of the fence post there watching a bull rider.
Yeah.
He's smiling through his tooth.
I know. Daddy always said no bull riders. Didn't mean you can't look. Right? Right.
Okay, we're going to play the game, Finish the Line. What we do is we play you a little piece of a song. We don't want you to tell us who's singing it. We don't want you to give us the title of the song. You have to sing the next line to the song. Listen close now. We only play this one time. Here we go.
It's boots and chaps. It's cowboy hats.
Okay. Can you sing the next line? We're going to find out. Ninth caller, you get the first shot. 725-5477. If you blow it, we go to the next caller, and they get a chance. 725-KISS. Good luck.
I'm not sure how I got here.
Thanks for making us part of your morning, Gary and Bristol, on KISS Country 93.7.
Jason, take a little ride. It's KISS Country 93.7. We're Gary and Bristol. Consolation Friday. We had our winner. We take a trivia, and it's like, you know what? Let's hand out a consolation prize because we found out that we had a 4-pack of tickets for the Ray Forcier Memorial Rodeo tonight and tomorrow night in Benton.
And, I mean, it'd be rude of us to hold on to those. You know what I mean?
Yeah, they just go to waste then.
I know.
So here's the deal. We're going to play the game Finish the Line. And your job is to listen to this song. We only play this little piece of it one time. All you have to do is sing the next line to the song. Listen close. See if you can win.
It's boots and chaps. It's cowboy hats. It's spurs and let it go.
It's a damn dull rodeo.
Not the one. Dang it.
The rope and the reins, the dust and the pain. They call the thing a rodeo.
One thing wrong with that, though.
Yeah, it's not right.
It's the ropes and the rain and the joy and the pain, and they call the thing rodeo.
Yay!
It's the ropes and the rain and the joy and the pain, and they call the thing rodeo.
So proud of you.
Me too.
And listen to me too. So, who is this?
Yeah.
This is Mary Kakay.
Well,
hey, Mary.
Hey.
You and that rodeo are going to be a thing tonight or tomorrow night. You pick which night you want to go. And we got you 4 tickets for the Ray Forcier Memorial Rodeo.
Oh, good deal.
Yeah, ain't it though?
All you got to do now is tell everybody who is Shreveport Bossier's number one for new country.
It's KISS Country 93.7.
Stick around. Just 15 more minutes. You won't believe what these two are going to do next. It's Gary and Bristol on KISS Country 93.7.
That one's new from Luke Bryan. Love you, miss you, mean it. Happy Friday, KISS Country 93.7, Gary and Bristol. Yeah, I've been confused too because somebody asked me about this not long ago when I said, oh, no. You know, I kind of sort of work in the illegitimate step cousin of the media.
Right.
And I know stuff like this.
Okay.
I was wrong.
So I thought we got rid of the sales tax weekends here in Louisiana because the legislature made a mistake. They can't return until 2025.
Yeah.
Yet we're having a Second Amendment sales tax weekend this weekend.
Right.
Okay.
Yes.
But we didn't have the school supply one.
No.
Because guns are more important than books.
Hey, it's Louisiana.
Okay. I'm just throwing it out there.
I'm just playing, yeah. Starting at 12:01 tonight, no state sales tax on anything that's kind of related to firearms, firearm accessories. They got your archery, all the archery stuff, P-Rows, range finders, knives, decoys, tree stands, blinds, chairs, holsters, belts. And now, this is the part that used to be, there's a change here because used to, there was no state sales tax also on things like ATVs and boats, animal feed or animals purchased for the use of hunting.
Okay.
And that would have included your deer corn, and protein
okay,
and stuff
it.
Like that.
Yeah.
Gone. Got to pay tax on that.
Oh, darn.
But, you know, there were times when, like, if you were buying a new boat or an ATV, I mean, you could save some bank.
It was up to a certain limit, right?
Yes, but still, you could.
Yeah.
And that was per purchase. Let's just say you'd been waiting all year and you bought an ATV and a boat and a whole bunch of corn the same weekend. Just look at the money you
Can
saved.
Can people do that still? I thought inflation and the economy killed that.
Well, I mean, you know, if you've just decided you're going to walk to work because you can't afford a tank of gas.
Oh, that's true.
KISS Country 93.7. It's Gary in Bristol. And, you know, the jury is still out with me on that.
What?
Is Post Malone, this whole album, which I have listened to, and I mean, there's really good stuff on there. But is Post Malone actually country enough for country?
No.
See? And have you heard the one, Pour Me a Drink with Blake Shelton that he's done?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
It's pretty good.
Yeah. And I'm like, okay.
I think we have to start redefining what country is.
Yeah, yeah.
I don't think Beyonce's country.
No, no. And that
but
one,
do
that
I
one
really like Post Malone with, yeah. you know, especially, you know, with Jelly Roll? Yeah. Know?
And there were those, I remember when Kid Rock and Sheryl Crow came out with Picture.
Yes.
And I was like, wow.
Good song.
I mean, you know, now Kid Rock is not country.
Now, do I think you're going to hear Texas Hold'em tonight at the Ray Forseer Memorial Rodeo?
Probably not.
No.
Probably not.
What are the chances of hearing Post Malone? Yeah.
Could happen.
I think so. Yeah. I think so. So, yeah, that's going down tonight and tomorrow in Benton. It's the Ray Forseer Memorial Rodeo. Willie Wagner Memorial Arena right there beside Benton High School.
And I don't know if you know this. Ray Forseer used to work right here in the room that we're in this studio.
I knew that you had some ties to him.
Ah, what a great guy. What a great guy.
Well, I got to tell you, I mean, the Lord is smiling down. He must have been amazing because tonight and tomorrow night, it looks like it is going to be perfect
Rain's
going to
end, yeah. It's cooler.
Yes. Oh, my gosh. So, check this out. Gate's going to open 6:30, but tonight and tomorrow, events start at 8. There's going to be all the different things that you've come to expect. There's the bull riding, the barrel racing, the steer wrestling, the calf roping, and especially the kiddos. I love this. The calf scramble.
Yeah, yeah. Every one of them gets a brand new dollar bill, and they have to walk through the whole audience showing off their dollar bill. You know, it's like, I got a dollar and you don't.
Well, funny man, Al Bryan's going to be there. And then Katie Lynn English. I don't know if you know her. I know her mama. She is a trick rider and she is bad to the bone. She is so stinking good. So if you haven't got your tickets yet, tickets are $10 for adults, $5 for children 12 and under. And I'm going to tell you what, just watching Katie Lynn, that's worth it. She that good.
On Shreveport Bossier's number one for new country. Kiss Country 93.7.
Next Saturday night, Brookshire Grocery Arena. He is going to be there. That's Cody Johnson, Dirt Cheap. Kiss Country 93.7, Gary and Bristol. Oh, and our buddy Mike Martindale is going to be there live for us in advance of the concert.
Oh, hey,
yes,
hey.
Yes, ma'am. And you never know what boy might hook you up with.
That would be very cool.
Yeah, you want to stop by and see him. Okay. And I have said for eons now, my cell phone sitting right here, just sitting on the counter. It's not, you know, it's not doing anything. I'm not actually, I promise you, something in there is listening to us right now.
It happens way too often where you'll talk about something, the next thing you know, an ad's coming up, a targeted ad. Come on.
Google and Amazon said, oh, no.
We'd never let our device listen to you.
But apparently, do you subscribe to the app 404 Media? Does all the news and stuff? Mm-mm. That's one of the ones I got. They just leaked a memo from a large marketing company where in this memo, they're bragging to their clients about a feature called active listening. They say it's not the first time they've been exposed for it. Cox Media Group actually bragged about it last year on their website. They took the page down, people freaking out. Looks like they're still bragging about it when pitching potential clients, though. Their leaked pitch says that they use artificial intelligence to capture real-time intent data. Like,
so if you're thinking about going and getting fried fish for lunch, like you just...
Hey, where do I go around here for some fried fish? Who wants whatever?
And then all of a sudden...
Boom! Everything
pops
up. Your
phone gets loaded. Okay.
Apparently, Google, Facebook, Amazon all say they are not involved in the program. Google even said they dropped the company from their ad partners program. Of course, the rest of us want to know, is it legal? Some experts say it's not. But the marketing company itself, the one that says, you know, in the memo, they're bragging about it. They say they think it is legal as long as software companies bury it in their fine print. And you know what? When you accept these apps and, you know, and it says, did you read the fine print? No, you didn't read the fine print.
No.
You didn't. You just said, yes, I did.
Mm-hmm.
They say it is totally legal for phones and devices to listen to you because consumers usually give consent when accepting terms and conditions.
You know, it's just like we were talking about yesterday with your satellite provider
mm-hmm.
who, you know, Well, you know, I know that we're not giving you everything you paid for, but you signed those terms and conditions.
Probably they're in the contract somewhere that says, oh, by the way, if we have to drop all the channels, you're still going to owe us $9 million a month.
At some point, the spirit of an agreement has to come into play.
Okay, so here's my question. Monday morning, I want to hit on this. Do you believe your cell phone is listening to you even when you're not using it? It's just laying over there on the side of your desk. Is it hearing your conversation?
And I promise you, we won't laugh at you if you say no. Sorry.
You said you wouldn't laugh.
I know. I had to get it out of the way.
Okay. Monday, is your cell phone listening to you even when you're not on it? What do you think? Or are we just being conspiracy theorists?
I swear mine is in my head.
All right. Make sure you wake up with us bright and early Monday morning. And don't forget, 7:15, we'll play ticket trivia again. And guess what? More Kane Brown tickets.
Yeah, baby.
Yeah, last week, though.
Almost as important as your morning coffee. It's Gary and Bristol, only on Kiss Country 93.7.